The Google Pixel 2 and 2 XL are two of my favorite Android phones, and though they lack some basic flagship features like wireless charging, a bezel-less display, and a multi-lens camera system, these almost year-old flagships from Google can still compete with the best of the best from other manufacturers on the market right now. And with the all-new Pixel 3 and 3 XL becoming official in just a matter of days at this point, we thought the Pixel 2 deserved to be revisited. How has this phone held up after a year? Have things gotten better, gotten worse? Is it still worth your money even today? Let's take one final look at Google's latest phone before it officially becomes last year's flagship. To make things easier for this video, I'm gonna be focusing on the larger of the two models, the Pixel 2 XL, because that's the model I spent the most time with, though almost everything I say about that phone can apply to both of these phones. And though they have a difference in screen size, both phones share almost everything you could have asked for back when a flagship was released in October of 2017. It's got a speedy Snapdragon 835 processor, 4 gigs of RAM, 64 gigs of storage, and USB-C on the bottom for charging. And the lack of wireless charging and the missing headphone jack were definitely deal breakers for some out there, though it's gonna depend on your use case. At least for me, the lack of the headphone jack wasn't that big of a deal. The wireless charging was, and still is today, very annoying, though it is in no way a reason not to buy this phone. These phones have definitely been no stranger to controversy. You may remember when they first launched about a year ago, we heard some issues of image retention or burn-in issues on the OLED displays. We heard problems of the screen being extremely dull and colors being very bland and a bluish tint on the screen out of the box. And some recent reports from Pixel owners say that the phones have been slowing down over time. The more they use them, the more they slow down. And to follow up on these issues with my own use case, I'm happy to say that almost a year later, I had zero issues with the screen. There were no burn-in issues or any image retention issues on the models that we have here. The colors are very muted on the Pixel 2 XL out of the box. I definitely recommend you go into settings and change the color profile to saturated for the display. It definitely is going to look way better in my opinion. And I can't comment on that last issue since I've been using the Pixel 2 XL recently with a clean install of Android 9 Pie, but I will say for the year we've had these two phones, everyone in the office, including me, has not noticed any slowdown issue. These phones seem just as fast as they were right out of the box on day one. The design of these phones definitely wasn't the most loved when they first came out, and 1 year later, they're starting to look even more dated when you compare them to the competition. And just because the design may be a little bit boring doesn't mean these phones are bad at all. 1 year later, they've held up incredibly well, and you are getting a larger chin on the bottom of these phones, but that does house a second speaker to give you a stereo speaker sound effect while you're watching movies or playing games or anything like that, which does make up for that little bottom bezel, and it does sound really good. And you will also enjoy the absence of a notch, which is most likely going to be a big part of the upcoming Pixel 3 XL. I also love the always-on display. It's one of those small features that I found myself using every single day, though I cannot say the same for that HTC-inspired squeeze to activate Google Assistant on the side of the phone. 1 year later, neither myself or anyone else here at TechnoBuffalo ever uses that. Okay, so I can't continue talking about the Pixel 2 if I don't mention the camera. It's one of the standout features about this phone, and it's what this phone is known for. And I can say in full confidence that the camera on this phone is incredible, and thanks to software updates, it just continues to get better. The combination of how well that hardware and software work together to take photos is incredibly impressive. And I know when I'm taking a photo on the Pixel 2 that it's gonna come out looking really, really good with little to no effort on my part and no post-processing needed for me to really get in there and edit for the picture to just look good. And what I love most about the photos that you're seeing right now is that they're not edited or touched in any way. They were effortlessly snapped in a rush. Portrait mode is also exceptional on both the front and the back lenses thanks to that Google software working its magic here, all without a second or even third sensor to provide additional image or depth data. Battery life has also been exceptionally good for me on this phone. I have to give some credit to the recent adaptive battery features in Android 9 Pie, but even before the update, I was still easily able to make it throughout a full day of use with some juice left to spare at the end of the day. Being a Google phone gives the Pixel 2 some unique advantages. It gets timely major and minor updates directly from Google, and it's as stock Android as you're gonna get on an Android phone while retaining a little bit of that Google flair on top. The Pixel series continues to push other manufacturers to step up their camera game, improve their onboard software, and in my opinion, continues to provide a tremendous amount of value for $649 or $849, depending on whether or not you want that larger display. Also to take note of, all this is just going to get cheaper and better when the prices drop on these phones when the Pixel 3 officially becomes available. And whether or not the new Pixel 3 and 3 XL are worthwhile upgrades from these phones is a totally separate video. You're gonna have to come back to the channel and stay tuned for that one. But revisiting this phone a year later shows that Google does their best to make good on their promises. They don't always get it right. They don't always produce the best looking phone, and they don't always have all the features that we may want. But they do provide a stable and secure Android experience with the promise of 3 years of updates, one of the best smartphone camera setups you can get right now, and components that won't be totally worthless or obsolete in a year's time. The Pixel 2 series of phones is a big step in the right direction from Google, and I am more excited than ever thanks to these phones to see what's gonna be new in the new Pixel 3 series. Though thanks to all those leaks, looks like we already know what's in store for those phones. So 1 year later, those are my thoughts on the Pixel 2 and 2 XL, but now I wanna know what you guys think. Are you owners of the Pixel 2 series of phones? What do you guys think about that camera? And what are you most looking forward to in the new Pixel 3? Leave your comment down below and let us know. Also, if you haven't already, hit that button so you are subscribed to the channel and click that bell so you're notified about upcoming videos as soon as they are published. I am Robert Rosenfeld from Techno Buffalo. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.